Greetings, my friends. The earth is falling apart right before our very eyes. I'm seeing it day and night, every day, every week, every month now. It's like birth pangs in a woman. The closer it comes to her delivering the child, the faster and faster, the nearer and nearer, the closer and closer the birth pangs become until the delivery. There's about to be a huge delivery in the universe, my friends. More on that later. The earth is falling apart. Look at this picture. This is a good photo of the earth being sucked out of shape, being just having huge astronomical pull and effect on the earth. A huge earth-shaking, earth-shattering universal event. A pulling, a snatching, a catching. Science and astronomy are baffled right now. They are baffled beyond belief. They can't believe what's been happening across the earth, north, south, east, and west, across the entire circumference of the earth for the past couple of weeks. It's picking up steam. I've noticed it here in Michigan. I've felt it. I've heard it. It's coming, my friends. It's coming fast. You better be prepared for what's coming. This is no joke. Let's go ahead and see what the news is saying about this, shall we? Boom. Mystery blasts rattling the globe. Are they meteors ushering in an asteroid? Is it Earth's crust and mantle shifting, falling apart? Is it the end of the world as we know it? Those are the questions experts and non-experts around the world are asking themselves in recent weeks. As curiously loud mystery booms have not only been heard around the world, but felt, shaking buildings, houses, stores, streets, fields, and rattling nerves from Alabama to Michigan to Idaho to California to Russia to Denmark. It is now being said the earth appears to be reeling to and fro like a drunkard. That sound familiar to you? My friends, I'm convinced that God is preparing the earth for the imminent snatching away. Remember I talked about that? Catching away. Remember I talked about that? It'll be a universal phenomenon like the world has never seen before. There will be billions of human beings being instantly, blink your eyes, that's how fast it'll be, taken away from the earth. All the children and the babies who the earth's leaders are now saying must go to be able to save the earth because of all of the global warming and the lack of resources. They'll get their wish soon because those children and babies are going to be gone. And us pesky Christians, not most Christians, will still be here with you because they're just like you. They just have asked Jesus at one point in their life to save them, but then they live like hell and like the devil, and they'll be right here with you. But the pesky Christians like myself and those of us who are sold out for Jesus Christ, those of us who actually repent of our sins after we're saved the way hundreds of scripture in the Bible command you to, you know, those of us will be gone. You'll be throwing a party when we're gone. You'll be terrified when your babies and little ones, loved ones are gone and snatched away, caught away. I believe God's preparing the earth, preparing the universe, getting everything ready. It'll be an intervention, a universal intervention. Like no one has ever even dreamed of in their entire life. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be so fast. I can't wait to get out of this filthy, evil, wicked, festering, fake, phony, sinful, terrible, hellhole, cesspool, sewer hole of a planet and of a country, America, that I live in. And I know many people get mad at me when I call America out, but I did 20 years in the military. Multiple frontline combat tours with the U.S. Marines. I got the right to say whatever I want to say about America. I paid with blood, sweat, and tears for this country. And I'm sick of it. It's not the same country that I fought for years and years ago. I'm so sick and tired of it. I'm sick and tired of all of the sinful, evil wickedness, of the sideshows going on all the time, the sidebar issues that are mostly lies and half-truths and all the innuendo and insinuations going back and forth now between everyone while they're just fiddling while Rome burns, while the core issues are being ignored. I just can't wait to get out of here. But until I do, whether it's going to be by rapture, harpazo, catching away, or death, whatever it is, I will keep telling you what's going on. I'll keep trying to warn you, trying to show you as an anointed watchman and pastor called by Jesus Christ himself to feed the sheep, to tell you what's going on, to warn you from the top of the wall at the dangers that are coming. I'll keep doing it until I can't do it anymore, because soon I'm not going to be around to tell you anymore. And then you'll deal with it by all by your lonesome, my friends. And all those cocky Christians who lie through their teeth about salvation, who tell everyone that salvation is a one-time thing and all your sins are paid for forever, you can, and doesn't matter what kind of sins you do afterwards, even if you're an atheist, even if you start worshiping the devil, it doesn't matter, you'll still go to heaven. They'll try to throw the caveat and they'll say, oh, those aren't real Christians, they're liars, and the truth is not in them, as the Bible says, because Jesus says that all, not some, not most, not 99%, but all who come to me and ask shall be saved. Those who are living the hellish lifestyles are backsliders, and that's the vast majority, sadly, of the church today. And they'll find out soon enough that I was telling the truth, because the Bible tells the truth. And all of you that lie in Jesus' name, I rebuke every one of you in the name of Jesus, and I command you all to get behind me, Satan, because yes, you are Satan. You are of Satan, your father, the father of lies. And I rebuke you all in Jesus' name. Get behind me. I'm sick of it. I'm not going to be held accountable one day before Jesus for not telling the truth, for not telling you what the Bible says, for not warning you what the Bible says, and I'll keep on doing it. Look at this earth, at this picture. Earth is going to be in such a bad, bad shape, my friends, sooner than you could even imagine. This is just trying to, again, trying to wake you up. God has been trying to wake us up with hurricanes and tornadoes and tsunamis and typhoons and half of the world on fire, half the world underwater from flooding and from terrible plagues and pestilence and diseases like smallpox and whooping cough and cholera and typhoid and all these other things are just making huge comebacks, and all kinds of untreatable diseases and untreatable sexually transmitted diseases and all the just terrible, filthy lifestyles going on. God's trying to warn us that he is about to put his foot down and take it, have Jesus Christ take his bride out of here, and then bring the tribulation and great tribulation, where for 7 years, or it's going to be 7 years, and it might be a lead up time to that, but it's going to be seven pure years of hell, where about 2/3 roughly of every human being is going to die the most grotesque, awful, terrible, horrific death imaginable to man. It's going to be worse beyond your wildest nightmare, my friends. And there's going to be just so many terrible things happening. You'll be told you have to take a mark in your right hand or forehead if you want to buy and sell, if you want to live. Take that mark. If you spend, you're marrying Satan for all intents and purposes. You spend forever in hell in the lake of fire as soon as you die. Refuse that mark. If you're saved by Jesus Christ's precious blood, you spend forever in heaven as soon as you wake up with your first breath of your new life. Because no one just goes to the ground and just rots with the worms. There's no purgatory, no timeout, no little bit in hell to pay your dues and get out. You spend forever in one of two places. Hell and the lake of fire, which are combined. Hell's is your initial holding point, the lake of fire after judgment day, or heaven. There's no in between, nothing else. It's just the way that it is. And there'll be such terrible things happening during this time, with asteroids hitting the earth and huge armies just wiping out billions, asteroid wiping out billions, disease, pestilence, and plague wiping out billions, the sun getting so hot it'll kill you, make you wish you were dead, and 100-pound hailstones crushing you, and just demonic, poisonous insects stinging you for months at a time. You want to die and you can't. Joblessness, homelessness, hopelessness, helplessness, anger, suffering, your babies and little ones, your children gone. And I believe you'll be told they were taken away to a nice, beautiful place with the aliens and a beautiful planet somewhere out in the cosmos where they're just loving life until the earth can be repaired to bring them back and reunite you one day. I believe they'll lie through their teeth, and I believe you'll buy it lock, stock, and barrel. You'll love that the Christians are gone, but you'll need an excuse to try to heal your heart after all your babies and little ones are snatched away, even out of your womb, and they're gone. There's no reason to go through any of that, my friends. Jesus Christ is your only hope. If you've never been saved or you're backslidden, pray the prayer, do the 6 steps I have in the box below the video. No one's guaranteed any more time in your life. If you'd like prayer, contact me. I pray for you every day without fail. True Christians look up, my friends, or different draweth nigh. We fly soon. Please share this video. I'm being censored relentlessly. Many don't want to hear the truth, but I will always get the word out. God's chosen will never be silenced. He's always in charge. All glory to him. Thank you. Bye.